Hello everybody, this is GamePro24X back again to give you guys more information about the current patch notes. Now, if you watched my previous video detailing the previous patch notes that we just got on Tuesday, on the Big Tuesday maintenance, you'll know that there have been some incorrect things that were not really addressed or not really fixed in that update. Now, normally, if it's not that big of a deal, Konami would just wait an additional week to finally iron out all the bugs and fixes and whatnot. However, sometimes, very rarely, if the problem is so big, they actually patch it immediately, like the very next day, which is what we got the next day. So yesterday, on the 4th, Wednesday, we got what I would call is an emergency patch note. Now, like I said, these don't happen very often, but that's what I'm going to call them for now on, because they are important patches that they put in immediately that just cannot wait for the next week to come by. So for this emergency patch, they fixed two things. They fixed a bug concerning the reward drops in salvage missions, because a lot of people were still complaining that they were not earning any epics or anything different really when it came to the salvage missions. Now, I have played a few missions myself, and I have noticed some changes. I did get some things that I would normally not get, but I have yet to actually get any epics myself. But mind you, I played like less than 5 games, so maybe if you guys have noticed it, definitely mention it in the comments. And the second thing that they fixed was the Cure Knuckle ability. So as I detailed in the previous patch note video, that it stated that Cure Knuckle will now heal 40% of your teammates' health. However, as I have demonstrated and explained and tested myself, that was not true at all. It still remained at 20%. However, now I can safely and confidently tell you that this has been fixed once and for all. So now we get a nice chunk of health every time we use Cure Knuckle. And after playing around with it for a while, I do see myself using that skill a lot more often than when it used to just heal 20%. Now it actually feels more worth it to heal your teammates with that. So 40% is a pretty big enough number, but not too big. So thank you, Konami, for finally fixing that. And I think that was a really fair balance towards that ability. Now, normally when Konami messes up on something, they actually do compensate the players for their mistakes. So if you happen to have logged in between these hours that have been stated, you will now receive 3 weapon cases and 3 gear cases, all legendary. And they will be in your supply box waiting for you. So that is about it for the emergency maintenance notes. However, I do want to go over some very small things that I accidentally left out on my previous video, and also some more information about a certain patch in the notes that I didn't have much clarification on, but someone else was kind enough to actually explain it to me. So the first thing I want to just mention is that prior to the recent update, there was an exploit when it came to the Lost Box. So basically what the Lost Box is, for those who don't know, basically if you go out into the field, you grab some stuff and you either quit the game, or not really quit the game, you either restart or quit back to base or you die, you'll actually have a exploration mission that says recover Lost Box. And basically this glitch allowed you to essentially duplicate your items. So you can go out and get like 10 bottles, like 10 empty bottles, do the glitch, and now you get 20 bottles. And if you did it correctly, not only will you just get more items, but you also, like, it does it immediately. Because from what I've heard, the Lost Box actually takes 20 minutes to complete, but a part of the glitch was actually doing some kind of time skipping method where they complete it immediately and you get all the loot that was inside the box and you effectively earn double. Well, since the patch came out, the people who were abusing this glitch, their accounts were locked, which I think it's kind of too harsh. Like, it says here that they already took away all the items, but I don't really think you should lock the people's accounts. Like, taking it away is already, like, I think that's sufficient enough, because, like, who knows? Like, you know the infinity farming glitch I have on my channel? Well, what if they decide, oh, that's cheating, and everybody who did this is now going to be locked? Well, now you practically just killed the majority of your player base. So I don't know, and I'm not really sure what the thinking was behind this. We don't have much clarity, but I kind of don't think that this glitch was so game-breaking that they got everything they wanted and they were getting all this cool stuff when in reality they were just getting extra materials for a lot less effort. So I don't know. You guys be the judge on that. So thanks to Dart for helping explain some of the things that I couldn't really explain myself. So let's go over what he has so kindly enlightened us on. So when it came to the attack patterns that were altered, it was very minor, but it was big enough to where it does change the difficulty of how you approach the Wanderers significantly. So pretty much when you're charging Wanderers now, they will actually start attacking before you get too close to them. Like once they see you and they see you kind of running towards them, they will immediately start like doing normal attacks or start winding up their heavy attacks. And I have actually kind of noticed that before. And I know before the patch they did do that sometimes, but now they seem to do it a lot earlier than usual. So use caution when engaging groups if you're trying to do a running attack. The best tip I can give you is when you run up to a group, do a run punch. And if they're all close to one another, you'll actually create a domino effect and you'll effectively like knock down the entire group. So then you can just step back a bit, do your run, and then do your running attack, and you'll be completely 100% safe as they will all be getting up, or most of them will be getting up during that entire time. Another thing that they fixed, apparently there was an issue with the pathing with the Wanderers. So on some maps, they would kind of get stuck in certain areas, and it would make the mission a lot easier since, well, you didn't really have to engage them that much, and they'll just be stuck, like, never getting out of wherever they are. So they kind of fixed that as well. When it came to the falling Wanderers giving you Kuban energy, well, it's supposed to pertain to if you had Wanderers fall from a high place and they fell to their death, you will now actually get energy from it. So I guess before this patch, you wouldn't get anything at all. So I would assume places like at the airport or anything else like that, you would have traps set up or air cannons where you would essentially blow away the Wanderers off the roof. They'll die from the fall, but you won't get any Kuban energy. And well, that's pretty detrimental as a strategy because now it's not really viable. But they since fixed that, so now that's actually something you can do and use it pretty effectively. And according to him, he's killed a lot of bosses already, and practically none of them gave him enhancing kits whatsoever. And as I've read around the subreddit, it seems that everyone else has come to the agreement that there's practically no reason to kill the bosses again because the loot rewards that you get from them are so minor for how much work you actually have to put into killing them that it's just not worth it. One purple case is what you're really after. The other cases don't really matter. And it's practically just either a weapon or a gear item. And you can easily get more of that by just doing co-op salvage missions like all day. So I'd say that until they adjust the rewards for killing these bosses again, I'd say skip them entirely. There's no reason to actually do it again unless you're trying to get certain achievements on particular bosses. And that about wraps up everything in terms of the emergency patch notes and additional information on the previous patch. So I'd like to thank you all for watching. Hope you found this information very insightful and very helpful. This is GamePro24X. And I'll see you guys next time.
Mission complete, and how? They're gonna tell stories about this one, boss.